Praise the Lord, and welcome to your real illuminating moment. I wondered if anyone realized that Christianity is not a creation of God or the Messiah, but of man. The two major umbrellas of the Christian faith, Catholicism and Protestantism, were all created out of the corrupt, rebellious, antichrist imagination of mankind and was divisive, political, greedy, and murderous from the beginning. Christianity does not resemble the original teachings and practices of the Messiah and the divinely chosen apostles. To the contrary, Christianity resembles the world of politics, business, capitalism, and enterprise. Contemporary Christianity appears to be a religious business enterprise that uses the Bible and the idea of Jesus as Savior to build its franchises, collect revenues, market and sell products, promote other like-minded religious entrepreneurs, entertainers, performers, and idols. Wake up, people. We have been thoroughly deceived, Revelation 12 and 9. We have been tricked, bamboozled, and hoodwinked into accepting the world's Christian corporations, institutional versions, and interpretations of God, the Messiah, and salvation without first searching the Holy Scriptures for ourselves and obeying God's eternal commandments, Philippians 2 and 12. We have been given a salvation placebo and are dying and perishing for lack of authentic salvation knowledge and genuine holiness. We have been fooled into believing that God instituted Christianity when in fact it was the enemies of Christ that maliciously and derogatorily referred to the saints of God as Christians, Acts 11:26. There is not one record in all of the Holy Scriptures where a saint of God referred to another saint of God as Christian. We have been deceived into believing that God instituted the particular Christian faith or church fellowship that we have chosen to be a member of, but that's not so. For there is no confusion, division, argument, or denomination in Yahweh. The Messiah was neither Catholic nor Protestant. The apostles did not teach unity and diversity, but oneness in the Holy Spirit, oneness in the holy ecclesia of the Messiah. 1 Corinthians 1 and 10, 1 Corinthians 14, 33, and Ephesians 4, 3 through 4. Yahweh never abdicated his sovereignty and authority over his ecclesia to any human agency or human being or religious institution or church. Don't get it twisted. Just because they call it a church or Christian doesn't mean that it belongs to God or serves God. More likely than not, they may be serving their religious Christian institutions and their pagan traditions. Just because a religious or ecclesiastical title is conferred upon an individual doesn't make that individual a chosen servant of God. They may be more a child of hell for having assumed a religious title than if they had not. And they may be serving and working for the institution in the guise of working for God. Wake up, people. The end time is here. 1 John 2. 17 through 19. We need to work out our salvation with diligence and not with the opinions of Christian theologies, Catholicism, and Protestantism. We need the authentic and unadulterated truth of the living Word of God that only comes from the ones whom God has specifically chosen, anointed, gifted, and sent to deliver His divine message of warning, repentance, forgiveness, salvation, and eternal life through His Messiah, His only begotten Son, Yehoshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ. Consider yourselves warned. Christianity is not the way of salvation. Obeying God is. Repent. Philippians 2, 12 through 18 tells us, therefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you both to will and to do His good pleasure. Do all things without complaining and disputing, that you may become blameless and harmless children of God, without fault in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation, among whom you shine as lights in the world. I'm O.W. Prince. Keep looking up.
Hash, hash.
Power, power. Purpose, purpose. On the O.W. Prince Ministries Broadcasting Network.
Hello, my dear friends, and praise the Lord. Thank you for sharing in this divine message from God. This is a free service of the Church of Jesus Christ and the O.W. Prince Ministries. You are invited to visit us on the World Wide Web at owprince.wordpress.com. That's owprince.wordpress.com. This ministry is entirely free of any religious, denominational, political, partisan, or secular influence. We deeply depend on the kindness and generosity of the saints. Would you please consider sending a gift of any size to the O.W. Prince Ministries, P.O. Box 3253, Sumter, South Carolina 29151. Again, that mailing address is O.W. Prince Ministries, P.O. Box 3253, Sumter, South Carolina 29151. Your love gifts help this ministry reach out to lost souls everywhere. No gift is too small. Every little bit helps. May the Lord guide and direct your giving and reward you openly for your faithfulness. I'm Bishop O.W. Prince, and as always in closing, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. Life hurts, but God heals.